देने പ്രതീക്ഷ. അപ്പൊ ഇതിലെങ്ങനെയാണ് മറ്റേ ഈ ഇതൊന്നും വരില്ല. നമ്മൾ ആപ്പ് എവിടെ ഇവിടെയാ അല്ല കേറി ആ മാഡം യു ആർ മാഡം അല്ല വേണ്ട ആ നേരിട്ട് ആ യു ആർ എൽ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്താൽ മതി മാഡം. മെയിലുണ്ട് ആ സോറി 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 ടിനോജ് ടിനോജ് ആണല്ലേ കേൾക്കാമോ? ഞാൻ ടിനോജിനെ സോ ഇതിന്റെ ഒരു ട്രയൽ ആണ് നടക്കുന്നത്. മറ്റുള്ളവർക്കും അതിൽ ജോയിൻ ചെയ്യാം. താങ്ക് യു. ടിനോജ് എക്കോ ഉണ്ടോ?
വിജി ചേട്ടാ ഒന്ന് പറയാമോ?
ശബ്ദം വ്യക്തമല്ലേ?
ആ ക്ലിയർ ആണ്, ക്ലിയർ ആണ്, എക്കോ ഒന്നുമില്ല. ഞാൻ പറയുന്ന കേൾക്കാൻ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടുണ്ടോ?
യെസ് മാം. മാം ഏതാണ് കുട്ടി എന്ന്? ഞാൻ വാട്സപ്പ് ഒന്ന് ഒന്ന് ഓപ്പൺ ചെയ്യും. വാട്സപ്പ് സോറി.
വിജീഷ് ഹലോ, കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ടോ?
വൺ സെക്കൻഡ് മാം, അതിലേക്ക് ഒന്ന് ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യാമോ? ഞാനോ ടൈപ്പ് ചെയ്യണ്ട. ഞാൻ മാഡം എങ്ങനെയാണ്, ലാപ്ടോപ്പിലാണോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇതിലാണോ ജോയിൻ? മാഡത്തിന്റെ മെയിലിലേക്ക് വന്ന് ചെക്ക് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ഞാനതൊന്ന് വാട്സപ്പിലേക്ക് ഒന്നുകൂടെ അയക്കട്ടാണ്. ശരി ശരി, താങ്ക് യു. പ്രവീൺ, കാൻ യു ഹിയർ?
ഹലോ,
യെസ് പ്രവീൺ.
ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ്,
കാൻ യു ഹിയർ?
യെസ്,
ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് ഓൾ.
good morning all.
Good morning, can you hear me?
Yes, you're audible. Good morning, sir. I can hear you.
Yes. Morning, Manan sir. Reverend, one second. Hindu. ഹലോ Fabian. Fabian. Can you please switch on your camera? Fabian. Praveen, can you hear?
Hello, Rajesh, can you hear me?
Yes. Praveen? വീഡിയോ കാണുന്നുണ്ട്, വീഡിയോ കാണുന്നുണ്ടോ? ഹലോ, പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ.
ഹലോ,
ഒന്ന്
അയച്ചിട്ട് വിളിക്കാമോ? അന്നലെ ആ മെസ്സേജ് കൊടുത്താൽ മതി. അതിൽ തന്നെയല്ലേ നമ്മളെല്ലാം ജോയിൻ ചെയ്തത്? ഇപ്പൊ ഹിന്ദുവിന് ജോയിൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ലേ?
Hello Dev, I'm only yeah, can you after the session keep calling. Sure, I will call. Thank you. Professor Menon, I have with you our host. And request that all the inaugural ceremony facilitators should be made co-host once they enter the platform. You can please notify me when they are here. And I'm also making Shanti and Levin our sign language interpreters co-hosts.
Yes. Praveen, Professor T. Aravind, he joined.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
You are audible.
All right, okay.
I will make you the co-host. Only co-hosts can mute and unmute themselves. Others who will be joining yes. will be muted by default. Request if okay. other speakers so, can speak, please kindly notify.
ഒരു പ്രിന്റ് എടുക്കുക ആ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ
let us can we have a round of mic checking by the main speakers? Can we start with Professor Menon?
Yeah, can you hear me? Good morning.
Thank you.
ഓഡിയോ I think both are okay. All right, so I can get in around 11 o'clock.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Joe, good morning.
Let me check it, sir. Yes.
The first one is from it's a very 1 minute with 1 minute animation. It's on the first phase of plus you can see yeah. Kerala was number one, and then you can see Kerala's moving down to the 10th position yeah. from 14th March till 10th April, and the second video is till 26th September.
Yes, sir.
It's also a very brief animation. If you can actually either during my talk or even before, if you want to show that, it'll be good. I'll make a reference to that in my talk.
So we'll try it, sir.
It is very useful. People who are actually there will be able to understand the way in which the COVID situation is actually worsening in many parts.
Yes, sir.
We also have district wise details. Once the data of the districts are also available, we can also do the animation district wise.
Yes.
If you have a laptop and which you can actually screen during the inaugural ceremony, I think it will be very useful.
Yes, sir. I'll try to stream it. So.
Yeah, it won't take much time actually.
Yes.
A very brief animation, but then it's actually to really demonstrate how the situation has actually been changing.
I hope video is something you have shared with me, sir. What's up?
I'll
share it on the screen.
Yeah, that time you can.
Santosh, good morning.
Fine.
Good morning, Professor Santosh.
You can unmute yourself. Professor Santosh, you can unmute yourself and test your microphones.
Hi, Professor Menon. How are you?
Good, good.
Sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Sir, we would be having sign language interpretation for all the sessions, and Shanti would be doing that. She is from National Institute of Speech and Hearing, NISH.
Okay. What is it? List it. Print.
Professor Menon, are you in Delhi or you are in in Kerala?
I am in Pune.
Oh, you are in Pune.
You have been looking at all the numbers, right? The COVID?
Yeah, I had sent the link.
Yes.
The various sources like WHO and COVID. Sorry, fine.
All theory.
But taking your mission, Professor Menon?
No, actually, I think, the government of Kerala, the COVID caseload, very, very, sorry? Yeah, I was saying that Kerala has been, showing the caseload truthfully and also the testing very truthfully, but it's not really doing that. I hope you agree.
Yeah, that's I agree because I have witnessed myself. Many of the states want that the kind of numbers it has gone high, and the capacity is not there to actually cope with.
I think from the. No, I think that's very funny. We had from 30 January till now, we're in almost September. So we had denied for progress and prompting with such capacity. But this is actually an opportunity for us to also introduce the situation and see how best we can see the disease spread. It is actually now going into the rural areas and to peri-urban municipal hospitals.
Yeah, very true. In the villages, things are very challenging because when cities doesn't much of capacity to take the patient and provide the immediate care. So many of them, even Delhi, where yeah. People are living in the staying at home and they're getting themselves treated by taking advice of the doctors over phone or something. They don't have the hospital capacity to go. Because my family, it's my cousin, his wife, two young children, his mother, all are affected by COVID. And except mother, others did not get this hospital facility. They are quarantined and they are getting medicine, whatever, on the advice and struggling.
Right. I think most of the others have joined. So, we can take this discussion offline.
Yeah.
After the session get over.
Now it is with the government of Kerala and also Vikram.
Santosh?
Yes.
Santosh, you can see this?
Yeah. Black one? Black.
Yeah.
This.
It is an idea.
yeah, yeah, got it. This bottle.
Water bottle.
Yeah, yeah. Good. Thank you for using it.
Yeah, and I'm also using this during some of the conferences and conference calls to doing your PR.
Oh, thank you so much. You are the alumni of an IDM, we always say.
Yes. This is also being streamed on YouTube and also on Facebook.
Which one?
This session. Is it being live streamed on Facebook and also on YouTube?
I think so.
We can't. No. No, we are not doing it today.
Oh, okay. Okay.
With a purpose or?
Sir, our member secretary, Dr. Shekhar, has also joined.
Okay.
Hi, Dr. Shekhar.
Dr. Shekhar, good morning.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Shekhar here, Vinod sir, I think Santosh ji, Vikrant, all of you. Hope I am audible.
Yeah, since you have a large Sanada Sena, you know, it would be good if the YouTube and Facebook also could actually reach out to large numbers, no?
Yeah, I'm not sure whether this is being streamed on our Facebook or YouTube. It's usually
not for today, maybe.
Yeah. I think Valsla ma'am has also joined now. Good morning, madam.
Okay.
So.
Good morning, everyone. I'm from Sri India. Thank you all for joining. Before we commence the session, I'll make some few administrative announcements. That we are using the WebEx platform here for the first time for the Sri India COVID-19 Academy session. As you can see, we have our sign language interpreters, Ms. Shanti and Mr. Living. Welcome, Shanti and Living. Thank you for joining and appreciate the call. I request the participants, as Shanti and Living are here, Shanti will be taking care in the first hour of the session, and the second hour of the session will be taken care by Living. I request the speakers to kindly slower a little bit when you are speaking. Do not request you to not pause so that Shanti and Living can talk of your speech. And also the participants, you will have an option if you go to the screen of Shanti, let's say as she is starting, you can see her explaining my word. If you go to her screen, you will find an option to lock her video. so that you will be able to see her throughout the session, irrespective of who is speaking at one point of time. That way you will be able to follow up Shanti or Livin throughout the session. And the speakers are being made co-hosts, so only co-host will be able to mute and unmute yourself. If any speaker is asked for any connection issue and dropped off and joined again, we request you to raise your hand. I will put it in the chat box that you have rejoined so that we can immediately make you co-host. എല്ലാവർക്കും നമസ്കാരം. നമ്മുടെ സെഷനിലേക്ക് വളരെയധികം നന്ദി. ഈ സെഷനിലേക്ക് സൈൻ ലാംഗ്വേജ് ഇന്റർപ്രിറ്റേഷൻ ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ശാന്തിയും ലിവിനും ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഫൗണ്ടേഷനിൽ നിന്ന് വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. താങ്ക് യു. നിങ്ങളോട് ഒരു റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ഉള്ളത് ശാന്തിയുടെയും ലിവിൻ്റെയും, ശാന്തി ആയിരിക്കും ഫസ്റ്റ് ഹാഫ് ഹാൻഡിൽ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ വീഡിയോ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഫുൾ ടൈം വിസിബിൾ ആവാനായിട്ട് അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ സ്ക്രീനിൽ പോയി ലോക്ക് വീഡിയോ എന്നൊരു ഓപ്ഷൻ ഉണ്ടാവും. സ്ക്രീനിലേക്ക് ആ വീഡിയോ നിൽക്കുന്ന സ്ക്രീനിലേക്ക് മൗസ് പോയിന്റ് കൊണ്ടുപോകുമ്പോൾ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മൊബൈലിൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നവർക്ക് മോർ ഓപ്ഷൻസ് കാണും. അതിൽ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ആ വീഡിയോ ലോക്ക് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള ഓപ്ഷൻ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടും. അങ്ങനെ നിങ്ങൾ വീഡിയോ ലോക്ക് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മറ്റ് സ്പീക്കേഴ്സ് സംസാരിക്കുമ്പോഴും ഇദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ ശാന്തിയുടെയും ഇതിൻ്റെയും വീഡിയോസ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എപ്പോഴും വിസിബിൾ ആയിരിക്കും. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു സെറ്റിംഗ്സ് ചെയ്യാനായിട്ട് റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യാണ് വീഡിയോ ശ്രദ്ധിക്കാൻ താല്പര്യമുള്ളവർക്ക്. ആൻഡ് താങ്ക് യു. And it's this, I request my colleague Vijesh to take over the welcome speech. Thank you. Over to you, Vijesh.
Praveen, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Thank you. So, good morning and a very warm welcome to the launching session of COVID-19 Academy Kerala. Ellavarkum namaskaram. I'm Vijesh, Program Coordinator, Sphere India, and on behalf of the Sphere India and the Kerala State Disaster Management Authority, I would like to thank all participants, guests, present here. COVID-19 Academy is an initiative of NITM, WHO, UNICEF, HCL, WHF, Sphere India, and other organizations. The COVID-19 Academy is a capacity building initiative with a mission to enable frontline workers and outreach workers. And Sphere India COVID-19 Academy has so far reached out more than 1 lakh people through more than 100 sessions. And here in Kerala, COVID-19 Academy Kerala initiative is a part of series of training sessions delivered in Malayalam language, organized by Sphere India in association with the Kerala State Disaster Management Authority and Kudumbashree. The Kerala Academy will have 12 technical sessions starting from 13th September, covering diverse topics delivered through this online platform. And the academic sessions are targeted towards participants from Kudumbashree, interagency group members, Apta Mitra volunteers, Sannadha Sena volunteers, Kerala Civil Defense Force, and persons with disabilities and from various academic institution. It is our honor to have with us today Sri Harikishore Iyer, Professor Santosh, Dr. C.T. Aravind Kumar, Dr. Shagaral Kuriakos, Professor Vinod C. Manon, Sri Sarajit Sahota, Dr. Valsala Kumari, and Sri Rafi, Father Saji Joseph, and Sri Vikrant Mahajan. We are very happy to welcome all of us here. And here we are pleased to welcome Dr. Shagaral Kuriakos, Member Secretary, Kerala State Disaster Management Authority. He is like always been our source of motivation and inspiration. The meeting will be presided over by Dr. Shagaral Kuriakos. Welcome you, sir. And we are honored to have with us Sri Harikishore Iyer, Executive Director of Kudumbashree. In his absence, it's my great pleasure to welcome you, sir. He'll be joining later. Thank you. And a very, very special welcome and thanks to Professor Santosh Kumar, an eminent scholar and professor in National Institute of Disaster Management. Welcome you, sir. And a noted educationist and an eminent teacher, Dr. C.T. Aravind Kumar, Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor Mahatma Gandhi University, and it's our proud privilege to have him as our guest. I welcome you, sir. And National Disaster Management Authority, always providing guidance and support in our humanitarian actions. And here we have Sri Nawal Prakash, Joint Advisor, National Disaster Management Authority. With great pleasure, I welcome you, sir. A retired IAS officer and a former Principal Secretary, Government of Kerala, Dr. Valsala Kumari. Once she had led the disaster management system in the state, and now, even now, also she is part of all the disaster risk reduction activities, initiatives of the state. I welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you.
And next, I welcome Professor Vinod C. Manon, former member of National Disaster Management Authority. He's an eminent scholar and a practitioner who always been on the front line in the fight in the flood 2018-19 and now in the COVID-19 pandemic also. And next, I welcome Sri Sarabjit Sahota, Disaster Risk Reduction Specialist, UNICEF. A structural engineer and humanitarian with more than 25 years of experience in disaster risk reduction and safe construction. With great pleasure, I welcome you, sir. I welcome Father Saji Joseph, Professor Loyola College of Social Work, and also we have Sri Rafi, Senior Program Associate, World Food Program, Kerala. Welcome you, sir. And now I welcome Sri Vikrant Mahajan, Chief Executive Officer, Spear India, who took a leading role in coordinating and facilitating many actors for COVID-19 Academy Kerala. We welcome you, sir. Now we have Mr. John George with us, State Project Officer, KSDMA. Welcome you, sir. And also we have our sign language interpreters with us from National Institute of Speech and Hearing. I welcome Ms. Shanti and Mr. Levin. Thanks for your service, and I welcome you. And yes, and I once again I welcome all our colleagues, participants from Kudumbasri, interagency groups, our Apta Mitra volunteers, Sannadha Sena volunteers, students from Marian College of Social Work, Loyola College of Social Work, all other students from other institutions. Welcome you all. And now I request Dr. Shekhar L. Kuriakos to present. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Vijish. Good morning. As such, Dr. Hari Kishore, sir, has informed that he has another meeting with the Principal Secretary, Local Self-Government, and he'll be joining in a while. He said he will, so we will have the formal inauguration speech when he comes in. But he has consented that we can carry forward our proceedings, and in the meantime, he might join by around 12 o'clock. That's what I have as information from him. It's a pleasure actually to host COVID-19 Academy and start the proceedings related to it. For the fact that KSDMA has been actively pursuing online training programs for different sectors, focusing on disability inclusive DRR or volunteerism. We have had conducted two rounds of IRS trainings for all the IRS faculty, IRS staff in the state, up to taluk level with the help of NIDM and NDMA. And when I saw this concept of COVID Academy, I just didn't stick to COVID because COVID would come and COVID would go, and there might be some other disease which will come and go. That shouldn't be a reason for us to host an academy and continue with its practices. So I requested some of the eminent scholars in the field of disaster management and also humanitarian action to join hands in this inauguration so that we could take forward this concept of online didactics to a different level over time and develop and mature this into a formal disaster management academy, online academy, so that everybody benefits from it in the long run. So hence I requested none other than our Pro Vice Chancellor Dr. C.T. Aravind Kumar, who also happened to be the former director of the School of Environmental Sciences, which had one of the oldest disaster management courses in this country, which is environmental science and disaster management. And he has now been elevated to the position of Pro Vice Chancellor of MG University. So it was very, it's actually a pleasure to have him on board. And then I requested Professor Santosh, who had been with us for a long, he has first-hand experience in Kerala in 2018, because he was one of the very first to come and start looking at what we were doing in Kerala and report to Government of India. So I requested him also to join hands. The reason why I thought of having our Father Saji from Loyola College, for everybody's knowledge, Loyola College very recently picked up, they have a very strong MSW course, which has created literally celebrities in the country. So they recently organized a meeting wherein I was also requested to participate, which I actively participated in, wherein Loyola is interested to start a course on humanitarian action, basically social work oriented humanitarian action disaster management. So they are in the beginning stage, and sharing a platform with Professor C.T. Aravind Kumar or Professor Santosh, Dr. Valsala Kumari, you know, the peers and contemporaries in disaster related education would help that institution to grow further. Father Saji will also be able to share his views about what they intend to do. You have great people here, Father Saji, like Professor Vinod Menon, who was one of the very first members of NDMA. There's long, long history in disaster management and humanitarian action. Valsala Kumari, madam, who had directly handled disasters in her capacity as our boss. So the whole idea is to bring the whole fraternity of disaster management together and think beyond COVID. So while COVID Academy might be delivering courses and small awareness programs for people related to COVID management, I see it as an online platform where we could celebrate disaster risk reduction by bringing people from all fraternity related to disaster management. And I think it is high time that we also have to start talking about disaster management in conjunction with humanitarian action, because that's more relevant in the context of changing climate and the increasing magnitude and frequency of disasters that we are seeing. There needs to be an inculcation of humanitarianism in everybody. Of course, when major disasters strike, people do come together. But beyond disasters, we don't keep that in mind as to why these disasters happen and what should change. This doesn't happen. So one of the goals that through COVID Academy we should achieve is to continuously provide a platform for the youth and the elders and anybody who is willing to work and willing to contribute to humanitarian action, have a platform to interact with experts. So I urge upon Sphere and Care to not stop it with COVID-19. COVID-19 will go. We will survive. Humanity will thrive. We have faced even graver disasters. So beyond COVID, there is a much larger mission that we as disaster managers have to undertake, or humanitarian actors have to undertake. So I request Sphere India in this occasion to think beyond COVID and convert this as a massive online platform for every stakeholder to come, interact, be with experts of the range of experts and stalwarts in the game, from Vinod Menon sir onwards, everybody who would be able to impart domain specific know-how or orientation. You know, one of my recent experiences, I must tell, in the process of implementation of Aptya Mitra, for those who doesn't know, is a large volunteer group which is created by with the support of NDMA. In Kerala, it is done in Kottayam. We have about 200 trained volunteers who have also response equipment available with them with the benevolent support of NDMA. Now, when we were doing this Aptya Mitra, we also converted the training materials into Malayalam. We conducted massive trainings with the help of Fire Academy. And you know what really helped at the end? When in 2019, or when Cyclone Gaja's influences were felt in Kerala, we had started a WhatsApp group wherein the Fire Force officials, the Fire Academy trainers, they're also there on board with this volunteers, the trained volunteers. And interestingly, the volunteers started asking questions. When Cyclone Gaja's effects were felt in a little taluk in Alappi district, which is a neighboring district to Kottayam, they responded in that area. When a child choked due to some blockage in her throat, one of these volunteers went and with the online advice of the trainer who trained him on how to avoid choking from the Fire Academy, he was able to save that child. The family was very appreciative, although nobody, neither the volunteer nor the family, wanted to make a bombastic announcement about it. We within the group knew that this was happening. So when you have a platform available for actors to come along with the domain specialists, and when it is open access, it would imply that people will ask questions, people will come up with practical queries, and that will also poke a lot of us to think beyond the books, think beyond what we have probably learned and patterned ourselves, and think out of the box and suggest ways and means of solving a particular problem. So this platform should be thought as a platform beyond COVID, and should be also made available to public on a routine basis. So with these words, I would obviously request Hari Kishore sir when he joins to inaugurate this session. But in the meantime, I request Professor Santosh to deliver the keynote address so that we proceed with the program, and as and when Hari Kishore sir joins, he will deliver the inaugural speech. Thank you, everyone. Once again, thank you, Sphere India, for once again joining hands with KSDMA. Sphere India and our association actually started in 2018 during floods, and we continued. They supported us in creating disaster management plans, the drafts for the districts, so the new updated versions of the DM plans are in the making. Just a benevolent support from Sphere India. The most important thing that I must point out about that support which we got from Sphere India is to create interagency groups in all districts and formalize it as a formal activity of the district disaster management authorities. This paved a long benefit during COVID-19. Every district could tap on the IAG groups and get volunteers and actively use them for COVID-19 action. So once again, I thank Sphere India for joining hands with SDMA and supporting SDMA in its endeavor and mission. With these words, I conclude. Professor Santosh, I request you to deliver your keynote address so that we are enlightened on what should be the course of COVID-19 Academy.
Thank you very much, Dr. Shekhar. Indeed, I am grateful to you. You have given me this opportunity to share my view, and also that how this COVID-19 Academy, which you have taken it forward from Delhi to Kerala. And my heartfelt compliments to you and the entire government of Kerala for taking capacity development as a kind of a serious intervention when it comes to the disaster risk reduction. I still remember when Vikrant, Samir, me, and all starting in the disaster risk management initiative in the country. And that time, we barely had this kind of a forum where we could express ourselves and we could provide learning to others and also bring many people on the board. Few limited trainers, few limited experts, and sharing their wisdoms and trying hard to work for the disaster risk management. And when we see today how process, how much we have grown up, especially when I'm talking about capacity development initiative. So I remember when we visited Kerala in 2018 and I met Dr. Sekhar there, that how SDMA is taken up the entire recovery process. And the way he explained and the way he was on top gear, the entire machinery of the government of Kerala, we could meet large number of people, officials, civil society groups, NGOs, and all. And the kind of knowledge which was generating during that period was enormous. Everybody whom we were meeting, that we were thinking how much and wealth of knowledge this person and institution is having, how this will be actually captured and disseminated to the larger audience. National Institute of Disaster Management at the apex body, as an apex body existing since 1995, and spreading, trying to spread its wings. And we had initially supported to state governments by creating centers with the hope, with the help of Ministry of Home Affairs. But unfortunately, after 10 years of being there with the states, very few states have been able to actually take this forward. And this, when COVID-19 came up and the initiative of government of Kerala came up to take this to Delhi, it was a kind of a amazing reality. And we thought, we were thinking that how we can go. And when we saw that it is dedicated for the frontline workers and it will go entire discourse in Malayalam. So this is a very uniqueness which is carrying. And why I was, what I was sharing, that my worry was the fathom of knowledge which is getting created in Kerala in 2018 flood, 2019 flood, in the COVID and the management of SARS. I remember when I was organizing on the 13th of February in Mumbai, with the III Insurance Academy, kind of risk transfer mechanism. And I spoke to Dr. Shekhar and also his principal secretary. And that time they all said that they will be coming, but they could not come. And then I was very surprised. And then I got to know that government of Kerala had quarantine, kind of a quarantine, that no state official will go outside and no outside movement would also be in the state to be avoided, especially the officials moving from Kerala to other states. But that was a kind of a, at that time COVID-19 was not in a kind of a full blue, what he said, a full, fully grown up in terms of the World Forum also. It was started in Wuhan and we were thinking that it is a kind of a local challenge and city of China will take care of that and things will not go beyond that. But now when today, as Professor Menon was also asking informally when meeting started today and talking about the data, what is happening today. And when we see today that all we were out from the mainstream of kind of a work, mainstream of the life, mainstream of social kind of connectivity. So in this, that the wisdom of technology actually prevailed and we got reconnected again through webinar with the seminars and also that digital technology. And then we at NIDM also started webinar and training programs online, where we are also doing work with the government of Kerala and other states too. But COVID Academy, when Vikrant also approached us, overwhelming response. We were overwhelmed the kind of work which they were doing. We said that why not get into partnership, some programs, so that say that the show must go on. And that kind of approach we took. And today now we have converted ourselves into kind of a complete e-intervention of learning. Probably maybe as we are seeing in the report that government is also planning to open partially some of the schools and trying to approach also those who are willing to come to their school or colleges. They can come, and those who are not coming to their school and colleges, they can still stay back home and continue their study. So in this blended learning kind of arena, which we are saying, the challenges are manifold to the trainers and also reaching out to the people. You gave a number in the beginning that more than 100,000 people have been approached by COVID Academy. So when we are partnering, we also see that it's multiplying manifold, that is creating multiplier impact. And what I see as this COVID-19 Academy, where NIDM is also supporting this initiative, that when we when Dr. Shekhar said that Loyola College is there, Kudum Sri is there, then Humanitarian Actions is highlighting and again. So how our program does not go for this COVID-19 Academy for the front runner, as we have seen that Kerala is a very, very decentralized governance system. And more than, I think, if I'm correct, correct me if I'm wrong, more than 6% of the budget is by the local bodies. And they are so strong. So, and if they are getting connected with this COVID-19 Academy there in Kerala, reaching out to the municipal workers, municipal corporations, panchayat people, panchayati raj workers, that would be a fantastic reach when we talk about even if sitting in Delhi or sitting in Trivandrum or sitting in other locations and reaching out to the last mile. And thanks to technology and thanks to initiative, just I would focus in the at the end three important thing. As we say in the training and information and public awareness, knowledge is one part which we can disseminate with the help of this digital for technology or digital academy. Where we are challenged, giving particular skills to the people. So devices could be, like Kerala is very ahead of time when we say, KSDMA is having a lot of technology system in place, a lot of GPS, GIS system in place, and they have the kind of a reading material, you can say, or the technical material with them, learning material with them, so that can be disseminated to this kind of a platform, this kind of a academy. So skill part, which I was worried earlier, that how this can be disseminated. Maybe Kerala could be one example on which we can also draw a learning from kind of each other's experiences. And then third comes to the kind of a behavior change. How the people, as you very rightly said, that COVID-19 is there, but COVID come and COVID will go. COVID is not going to stay here forever. Gradually, it will, but some other disaster would be there. Some disasters there, like in COVID-19 also, we have seen how Kerala got affected by severe landslides, severe floods. So the academy should start focusing just not on the pandemic issues that we are doing it in Delhi with the COVID. Large number of areas which are the need of the state, like how to go for the cascading model of disaster training. Like we have rains, heavy rains leading to landslides, leading to inundation, and or leading to this housing collapse, and so on and so forth. And every time, like if it is happening in that this COVID time, the protocol of social distancing or physical distancing, observing, responding to all kinds of disasters are there. So it's a kind of a multi-hazard approach with COVID. 19 Academy should focus, and also join hands with NIDM NIDM has larger modules on community capacity also that we are doing already incident response system. We are having community-based disaster management. We have village development plan and so on and so forth. So whatever Kerala government is taking initiative and taken initiative in last 3-4 years, that could also come to the state level, to the national level, and that could be disseminated to other states also through this kind of a partnership. And we can also share a good example of yours, like Udhamsiri is a example which we wanted to study, that how they have taken up the work. So those kind of a exchange of ideas and exchange of learning process and exchange of literature and experience, which can also help other states to emulate. So that would be a very, very kind of an insightful investment of our time and taking it to the kind of a logical. It's going to be a continuum. Disaster will be there and the kind of climate change challenges are there. So collectively with the other wisdom, we can integrate in our framework, and our framework and our strength can be integrated in other states on the national framework as well. So this kind of a partnership will continue. And I extend my heartfelt thanks and congratulations to Vikrant and also Dr. Shekhar, Government of Kerala, on behalf of National Institute of Disaster Management. Professor Menon is here. So I, on behalf of the National Disaster Authority, I extend my heartfelt thanks to and congratulations to this wonderful initiative. And I'm always there, and NIDM always there. I am always there in personal capacity and also as an IDM in the official capacity, with wherever, whichever way we can help in strengthening our partnership, College Pudumsri, and also the State Disaster Management Authority and the COVID-19 Academy. Dr. Sekhar, thank you very much once again for giving me this opportunity. I know that capacity development is a very, very software kind of a thing. And everybody loves investment in hardware. So hardware is visible and software is invisible. With this kind of support, initiative, we can make this invisible visible. So that is why we are saying that this is capacity development initiative is very, very, we may ignore, but we can longer to it. Thank you so much. And thank you.
Thank you, Professor Santosh. It was very enlightening, and those words I will quote from you. Now I request Professor C.T. Aravind Kumar, Pro Vice Chancellor, MG University, to deliver a special address. Sir, you have had been managing the disaster management course in MG University School of Disaster Management, School of Environmental Sciences. Your enormous experience in education, we should capitalize and utilize more for public education in the sector of disaster management. So we request you to deliver the special address with highlights on what and how you think this COVID Academy in Kerala should progress. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming on board.
Good morning, all. I hope I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So on the outset, I thank the organizers, particularly Dr. Shekhar Kuriakose, for the invitation. In fact, I very much admire his hard work and dedication, which made this SDMA very visible in the state of Kerala, particularly in the last couple of years, right from Oki, and now we are in the midst of everything. Now, at the same time, I wish all the success for the COVID-19 Academy Kerala, organized by Sphere India in association with SDMA. And Kudumbasri. As Dr. Shekhar mentioned, in fact, we have a department, School of Environmental Sciences, under which we have a course, MSc in Environment Science and Disaster Management. And I'm really happy that some of our students are already actively involved in COVID-related activities and other disaster disaster management activities in the state as well as in the country. And also we have a department, School of Behavioral Sciences, which takes care of studies related to challenged people. And they are also involved in their own way in the management of this psychological management of this COVID-19. Now, I'm not going to give kind of too much technical details, but some of the comments just I want to make about this disease. Now, the year 2020 started with the casual airing of the coronavirus. And now with the single popular word, COVID-19. Now, COVID reported case in the global level is now almost about 33 million, and the death is about 1 million. India has about 6 million cases, and death goes to about 97,000, et cetera, et cetera. Now, this pandemic initially started as a health crisis. Now, it is far more than that and is now affected in all walks of our life, such as education, economy, livelihood, human relation, communication, etc., etc., in the micro level and macro level, from a regional level to a global level. When an epidemic spreads beyond a country's borders, it is officially called as a pandemic. We all know this. Now, throughout the history of mankind, such pandemic had a big role, and somehow people managed this in their own way at that point of time. Now, although such communicable diseases existed during the entire history of mankind, the shift to agrarian life 10,000 years ago created communities that made epidemics more possible. Now, malaria, tuberculosis, leprosy, influenza, smallpox, other such things, such diseases, first appeared during this period. The earliest recorded pandemic passed through the Ethiopia and Egypt before it wiped off 2/3 of the Greek societies of Athens, almost about 430 BC. It caused their defeat in their own ongoing war with the Spartans and redirected the course of Western civilization. Then the Antonine Plague of 165 AD, when smallpox spread from the Huns to the Germans, who passed it to the Romans. The returned soldiers from war and spread it throughout Roman Empire, taking out even the Roman Emperor and changing the course of Roman and world history. Now, the smallpox in 250 AD, the 11th century leprosy, which had been around for subsequent years, the bubonic plague of 1350, which only 2/3 of the world's population was left standing after spreading from Asia to Greenland. The 1800s witnessed the first of no less than 7 cholera pandemics over the next 150 years. However, I just mentioned all this to tell you something about the recent activities or how people have to manage the new pandemic in the new era. Now, there is a difference between earlier period of time and the present period, the so-called modern world. The more civilized humans became, building cities and forging trade routes to connect with other cities, states, and countries, and waging wars with them, the more likely pandemic became. If we carefully looked at the way our life reoriented each pandemic in the history, a lot of things to be learned. Now, humans learned a lot from this. At the same time, he did not learn too much. so is the present COVID-19. Now, coming to the human relations and the pandemic. On one hand, there are tremendous unity among people to fight the pandemic. This is what we see all over the world. At the same time, there's a fear among the public. And this led to a kind of untouchability issue in the society. We are not sure who has this disease, particularly at this point of time in Kerala too, the same case. So a kind of suspicion. On the one hand, there is a common concern shared by all. On the other hand, people possess materials by themselves. The impact is massive, as we all know. Our health system itself is critically evaluated. How do we tackle when there is a health disaster in the entire society, entire country? There is no single solution to this, nor I want to personally suggest any such solution. It needs a fresh look. So as in the case of our entire economy, a wide discussion on the Gandhiji's self-reliance all over the world. This is against the existing globalization. Our education system is also under revamp. I don't have to explain this. Now, coming to the traditional class of vulnerable people, the women, children, physically and mentally challenged, they are all vulnerable here too. They are the one who always suffer a lot. This is again a subject of discussion. Now, anyway, the present condition is that the entire world is coming to a common conclusion that learn to live with the pandemic. In the modern world, we live without much fear. There was a time when man lived in the jungle, having wild animals and other hostile surroundings. Then he was very careful and studious. Do we have to lead such a life in the present life, present time? Hope will deduce a better solution for all such pandemic. So here comes a kind of difference in deducing the protocol for any kind of training. So we have to consider all these things. And this is very different, probably very different compared to other disasters. Here comes, of course, the vital role of such a process by disaster management authorities and other groups. Now, the capacity sort of components, such as infection prevention and that is one aspect. Now, addressing outbreak in densely populated areas, which is actually different from other. For example, we realize now that the situation in western middle part of India, western and south part of India, and the eastern part of India. Similarly, the countries is like Scandinavian countries where the population is very low, and highly populated countries. And at the same time, populated country like China. What is happening there? I'm not very sure about it, but still, whatever we get from the newspapers and other media, they have also a control. So we have to see all these aspects. So in addition to this kind of control measures, addressing outbreak of, this is what I just mentioned, that waste management is equally an important thing during this pandemic. New technologies, innovative technologies, wash, gender-based violence, and psychosocial support, upkeeping the social balance, after all, a kind of confidence building in society. I think the most important part of this kind of a protocol, a program, is basically the most important thing is a confidence building in society. And the list, of course, goes much higher. So I'm very sure this kind of endeavor will get all support from the society, definitely. we are all with you. And I respectfully place on a record the enormous work of the people involved here, other groups. So again, thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you, Hari Kishore sir. Thank you, Arvind Kumar sir. It was very enlightening, particularly the history of how pandemic emerged. Valsala madam, madathinte mic idanu unmute aanu. Now I request Sri Naval Prakash, Joint Advisor, NDMA, to deliver his felicitation speech. Navalji, hello. Navalji, am I audible? Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah. Hello, Navalji. Yeah.
Yes. Good morning, everybody. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, but I think we can't see you yet.
Yeah, that's why I've already written there is some technical issue. In fact, I'm joining this meeting from my room itself because our control room, which is the ops room, is busy for another meeting, and in fact, I have to leave for another meeting also. So I just express my sincere apology that I could not, I won't be able to join the whole session. But on behalf of NDMA, I wish all the very success to this initiative of launching this COVID-19 Academy at Kerala. And NDMA would also like to get the feedback from KSDMA on this initiative. And since you have successfully implemented this Aapda Mitra scheme in Kerala, so how can you include the Aapda Mitra volunteers in COVID-19 Academy? We would also like to have some suggestions from you. That's it from my side. I have to leave. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Navalji. As such, Aapda Mitra volunteers are also attending this inauguration session already. We will be using their technical skills and experience sharing in the platform of COVID Academy so that we know what they did. For example, our Aapda Mitra volunteers have had been helping in our disability inclusive DRR program. During the complete lockdown, we had issues where people with hearing difficulties were not able to buy batteries for their cochlear implants. And our Aapda Mitra volunteers bought it from some places and distributed it widely among those who were struggling to hear and have these batteries bought. So a lot of initiatives, a lot of work is being done by Aapda Mitra volunteers. That's a story on its own to tell. And one day, COVID Academy, I hope, will host only the experiences of Aapda Mitra volunteers, Sannatham volunteers, and civil defense on during the times of COVID. So I now request Professor Vinod C. Menon to deliver his felicitation address.
Thank you very much, Dr. Shekhar. And partners for the academy, the COVID-19 Academy Kerala is a very good initiative, and I'm sure that with the support of hello.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Participate
society organizations, another it's a bit special. The pandemic situation,
Vinod sir, we are not able to hear you. The voice is breaking.
Cynic is something different as the synergistic, evolved series of epidemics, two or. A burden in.
If I may interrupt.
Sir, we are not able to hear properly. Vinod sir, we are not able to hear you clearly. Can you maybe try switching off the video?
Just a minute. I will switch.
Sir, please reconnect it, then it will be okay.
Yeah, are you able to hear me now? Hello.
Yes, sir. Better.
Yes. I'm sorry about that. There has been some interruptions because of internet fluctuations happening. I was thinking that actually, the way in which Kerala has responded to COVID-19 from the time the first case happened in Kerala on the 30th of January, 2020, may I request Praveen to kindly share a brief animation. It's a 1 minute animation. Can you just show how Kerala handled the first wave? Praveen? I will also be sharing how from 30th January 2020, how we have actually been seeing the way in which, COVID has actually evolved dynamically in Kerala.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, you can see the Kerala's COVID cases going up, and Kerala will move into the position of being the state with the highest caseload, by the time the lockdown begins, lockdown one. You can see that change happening. And you can see the way in which the caseload is increasing during the lockdown, with people traveling across states, people going back to the villages. And you will see this by the 20th of April, we will actually be seeing that we have the, by the 10th of April, Kerala comes down to the 10th position. You can see this moving down. Kerala is moving down to the fourth position now. Fifth. You can see this position of Kerala going down to the 10th position by 10th of April 2020. And we must compliment the response of the frontline health workers, the government of Kerala, the civil society organizations, the district administration, the elected representatives, the local self-government, Kudumbashri volunteers, all of them have been very actively involved in the response during the first wave. May I request Praveen to show the second one from 30th January all the way to 26th September. It's a very brief animation. Please kindly bear with me. It's important for us to understand this because, the way in which the caseload is actually spreading from the cities to the rural areas, because people come from the rural areas to the cities. Praveen, can we have the second one, please?
Sure, sir.
We see this spread happening in many states in the country, and we see the caseload increasing, and we also see the the people desperately running for hospital beds, ICU beds, ventilators. And in Kerala right now, we have witnessed 697 deaths. There are 380 people in the ICUs, and there are 92 people on the ventilators right now. So the situation in many other states are very different. You know, we also see large numbers of people, you know, in ICUs, in, you know, basically being treated on ventilators. Praveen, can we see that?
Yes, sir. Sharing again. Please hold on.
The second one. Yeah, this is actually showing, you know, from the time the COVID caseload started breaking out in India, in across the states, how the COVID has been actually spreading in various states. And you see the caseload increasing in states like Maharashtra. You can see that this is starting from, you know, the period from 15th March onwards.
Is my screen visible?
Yes. It's also showing the district-wise, you know, cities with the different districts. You can see the districts coming up, and you can see also the districts in Kerala. You can actually see that. Okay, I think we can stop here. Maybe, you know, you can share this in the group. They can actually see this. I don't want to take much time. Basically, I think we need to really understand how the caseload has been erupting and how we need to control us, you know, the caseload. Kerala has been reporting more than 179,922 cases. And right now we have about 57,882 active cases. And every day we find the caseload increasing. But, you know, the numbers of the new cases are going up. But we need to also understand that with increased testing, we will actually see the caseload increasing because more people who are infected and who are actually also likely to infect others through their primary contact and secondary contacts, we need to be really working on that. So I feel that Kerala's reporting has been extremely transparent, and I must compliment the people who are actually doing this tracking. We can monitor this very closely and see how this is actually happening. And I would like to also compliment the Loyola College for starting this program on social work with disaster management. There are many colleges actually conducting these kind of programs. Amrita University is also having a program on social work with disaster management. Don Bosco colleges are there, then Madras Christian College is there, Delhi School of Social Work is there. I would like to basically explain the opportunity which is available now. This is something where it's going to be a long haul for the COVID response. And so I feel that COVID-19 Academy would actually bloom to create public awareness. And we would need to really create public awareness on mask wearing, on frequent hand washing, and also in maintaining physical distancing in crowded places, because that is the only way we will be able to really contain the spread of the disease outbreak. I would also request all the ATM cash delivery machines, you know, vehicles to carry recorded messages to the communities in villages, in districts, in cities, and also all the PCR vans to be carrying these kind of messages to the public for, you know, enforcing better discipline. Thank you very much. Assuring you all support for the good work that you are planning ahead in the coming days. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vinod sir. It is a pleasure to have been working with you for a long time now. When we started in disaster management, we heard about you, and then you came down to Kerala to meet us. So it's a long, long time. Sarabjit ji, I request you to deliver your felicitation address. Sarabjit sir, are you there? Earlier I saw Sarabjit ji.
Good morning, Shekhar, and
voice too audible.
Sarabjit sir, we can't hear you now. Your audio has broken.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you, Shekhar, for partnering with COVID Academy for taking the ball state to catch it hard and hit it hard. And our experience of running the COVID Academy in partnership with Sphere. It really is a very good platform for a large number of agencies to come together. In the first phase of the COVID Academy, more than 60 agencies came together to deliver learning. And as you mentioned, Shekhar, experiential learning, the inductive learning through experience sharing. Congratulate you and Sphere India and NIDM, NDMA for enabling the COVID Academy in the phase two. Phase one was a big success here in Delhi, and we have learned that all the state, national, local boundaries have been dissolved by using technology. We continue to use our borders to term that this is a Kerala Academy, this is a Bihar Academy, partly because we will be using more local languages to deliver the courses. Otherwise, the experience sharing, cross learning among states, among districts is a big agenda of the COVID Academy. And I think under your leadership, we'll see more experiences being shared out of Kerala to be shared across the country. And as Vinod has already sort of given us a sort of a hint, and it's all visible that how well Kerala has done in terms of containing and managing and also taking some positive action on COVID-19. One of the core sort of themes of COVID-19 Academy in the phase two is to deal with overlapping hazards. As Professor earlier alluded to, that COVID-19 direct impact is limited, but indirect impact is huge on each and every sector. And I think if COVID Academy can contribute to learning, developing newer attitudes, developing newer practices to address some of these consequences of or the secondary hazards which have emerged out of COVID-19, be a great help. So I'll stop here. Again, thank you KSTMA, thank you Shekhar, thank you Vikrant and Sphere India for taking the COVID Academy to Kerala. Look forward to working with you, and absolutely our the point which Shekhar made about continuity is definitely on our minds, and the continuity of COVID Academy I trust will be the core sort of theme which some of us we will be discussing with Shekhar in the coming months and years, and universities for sure have a big role in ensuring that the university So over to you, over to the host, and thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, Sarabjit ji. Now I request Valsala Kumari madam to deliver her felicitation address.
Respected Sarabjit ji, Vikram ji, Shekhar Priya Kos, Professor Vinod, Professor Aravind Kumar, Father Saji, and all of the respected people who are gathered here for the COVID-19 Academy launch in Kerala. I have been asked to speak in a hybrid language of Malayalam and English because the audience comprises of a large number of people who are from Kerala. Therefore, forgive me if I use both Malayalam and English, and the time allotted to me is just 5 minutes. I'll try to be very brief. ഗ്രീക്ക് തത്വചിന്തകനായ പ്ലേറ്റോ ആണ് ആദ്യമായിട്ട് അക്കാഡമി എന്നുള്ള പദം ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നത്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ വിജ്ഞാന വ്യാപനത്തിനുള്ള ഒരു സമ്പ്രദായമായിരുന്നു അക്കാഡമി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അവിടെ പ്ലേറ്റോ തന്നെ പഠിപ്പിക്കൽ എന്നുള്ള ഉപരിയായിട്ട് ഓരോ ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കുകയും ഡയലോഗായിട്ട് ഡയലോജിക്കൽ മോഡിൽ കൂടെ ആശയവിനിമയം നടത്തുകയും അതിലൂടെയാണ് പുതിയ പുത്തൻ അറിവുകൾ ഉദിച്ചു വന്നത്. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഇതിനും അക്കാഡമി എന്നുള്ള നാമകരണം ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത് കാരണം തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും COVID-19 മാത്രമല്ല അതിനുപരിയായിട്ടുള്ള പല കാര്യങ്ങളിലുള്ള വിജ്ഞാനങ്ങൾ ഈ COVID-19 അക്കാഡമിയിൽ നിന്നും ഉടലെടുക്കും എന്ന് ഞാൻ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു. ഈ ഞാൻ പ്രധാനമായിട്ടും ഊന്നി പറയാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ ഫ്രണ്ട് ലൈൻ വർക്കേഴ്സിൽ ബഹുഭൂരിപക്ഷവും സ്ത്രീകളാണ്, നഴ്സുമാർ. നമ്മൾ കഥകൾ പലതും പറഞ്ഞിട്ട് 8 മണിക്കൂർ ആ പല ലെയർ പ്ലാസ്റ്റിക്കിനുള്ളിൽ നിന്ന് വിയർത്ത് പണിയെടുക്കുന്നതും ഒന്ന് ബാത്റൂമിൽ പോലും പോകാൻ സാധിക്കാതെ കഷ്ടപ്പെടുന്ന ധാരാളം സ്ത്രീകളുണ്ട്. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഭിക്ഷക്കാരന്മാരിലും ഏതാണ്ട് 50% സ്ത്രീകളാണ്. ഇവരൊക്കെ സ്വന്തം ജീവിതം പണയപ്പെട്ടിട്ടാണ് കോവിഡിന് വേണ്ടി പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ ഇതിലൊരു പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട കാര്യം, ഇപ്പോൾ വിഭവങ്ങളിൽ പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഒരു ഭാഗം COVID-19 അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡബ്ലി സോ, യു നോ, ദി റിസോഴ്സസ് ആർ ബീയിങ് ഡൈവേർട്ടഡ് ഫോർ റെസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ടു COVID-19. പക്ഷെ അതുകൊണ്ട് സംഭവിക്കാൻ സാധ്യതയുള്ളത് സ്ത്രീകളുടെ റിപ്രൊഡക്റ്റീവ് ഹെൽത്തിന് വേണ്ടി ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ട വിഭവങ്ങൾ പലതും അതിനുവേണ്ടി ഉപയോഗിക്കാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നില്ല. അതുകൊണ്ട് ധാരാളം സ്ത്രീകൾക്ക് കഷ്ടപ്പാട് അനുഭവിക്കാൻ സാധ്യതയുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ള ഒരു പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട കാര്യമുണ്ട്. രണ്ട്, ഈ കോവിഡ് വൈറസിന് ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ എക്സ്പോഷർ ഉള്ളത് ആ വൈറസിനെ വൈറസിനോട് എക്സ്പോസ് ആയിട്ടിരിക്കുന്ന പുരുഷന്മാരാണ് സ്ത്രീകളെക്കാൾ. ഇപ്പൊ നമ്മൾ മരണസംഖ്യയൊക്കെ നോക്കുമ്പോൾ പോലും പുരുഷന്മാരാണ് കൂടുതൽ മരിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പോ അങ്ങനെ മരണം സംഭവിക്കുമ്പോൾ, കുടുംബനാഥന്മാർ മരിക്കുമ്പോൾ, കുടുംബത്തിന്റെ ഭാരം മുഴുവനും, സാമ്പത്തിക ഭാരം മുഴുവനും സ്ത്രീകളിലേക്ക് പതിക്കുകയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ അവർക്ക് സ്ഥായിയായിട്ടുള്ള, സ്ഥിരമായിട്ടുള്ള, പരമ്പരാഗതമായിട്ടുള്ള ആ ട്രിപ്പിൾ ബേർഡൻ, അതായത് പ്രൊഡക്റ്റീവ്, റീപ്രൊഡക്റ്റീവ് ആൻഡ് കെയറിംഗ് റെസ്പോൺസിബിലിറ്റീസ്, ആ 3 ഉത്തരവാദിത്വത്തിനും ഉപരിയായിട്ട് സാമ്പത്തികമായിട്ടുള്ള ഉത്തരവാദിത്വം കൂടി ഏറ്റെടുക്കേണ്ടി വരുന്നുണ്ട്. ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കണമെങ്കിൽ COVID-19 എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ ഒരു പുതിയ ഒരു ഫിനോമിനൻ, ഇറ്റ്സ് ആൻ അബ്സല്യൂട്ട്ലി ന്യൂ ഫിനോമിനൻ. അപ്പൊ അതിനെപ്പറ്റി ഈ ആരോഗ്യ മേഖലയിൽ ഉള്ളവർക്ക് പോലും സമഗ്രമായിട്ടുള്ള പരിജ്ഞാനം ഇല്ല. അപ്പോൾ ഡേറ്റ കളക്ട് ചെയ്യുക എന്നുള്ളത് വളരെ പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഒരു കാര്യമാണ്. അപ്പൊ അതിൽ ആ ഡേറ്റ കളക്ഷന് വേണ്ടി നമ്മുടെ കുടുംബശ്രീയിലെ സ്ത്രീകൾ വളരെ പ്രാഗൽഭ്യം ലഭിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളവരാണ്. അവർക്ക് പലതരത്തിലുള്ള ട്രെയിനിങ് ലഭിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. അപ്പൊ കുടുംബശ്രീ പോലുള്ള സംഘടനകൾ, സ്ത്രീ സംഘടനകൾ ഡേറ്റ ഗ്യാദർ ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ദയവ് ചെയ്ത് അത് സെക്സ് ഡിസാഗ്രിഗേറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഡേറ്റ ആയിരിക്കണം. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഏജ് ഡിസാഗ്രിഗേറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള കണക്കുകളായിരിക്കണം. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഡിസബിലിറ്റി ഓർ എബിലിറ്റി ഡിസാഗ്രിഗേറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഡേറ്റ ശേഖരിക്കുന്നതിൽ പ്രത്യേകം ശ്രദ്ധ പതിപ്പിക്കണം എന്നാണ് എൻ്റെ ഒരു അഭിപ്രായം. രണ്ടാമത്, ഈ COVID-19 അക്കാഡമിയുടെ നേതൃത്വത്തിൽ തന്നെ ചെറിയ ചെറിയ പൈലറ്റ് സ്റ്റഡീസ് കുടുംബശ്രീയെ കൊണ്ട് ചെയ്യിപ്പിക്കാൻ സാധിക്കുമെന്ന് ഞാൻ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു. അതായത് ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു പഞ്ചായത്ത് എടുത്തിട്ട് എങ്ങനെയാണ് അവർ COVID-19 വളരെ വിജയപ്രദമായി തരണം ചെയ്തത്, അവർ നടത്തിയ ഹ്യൂമാനിറ്റേറിയൻ സർവീസസ് എന്തൊക്കെയാണ്, അങ്ങനെയുള്ള പല കാര്യങ്ങളും. COVID-19 എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അതൊരു ബൃഹത്തായ ഒരു വിഷയമാണ്. അതിൻ്റെ നാനാവശങ്ങൾ പഠിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി കുടുംബശ്രീയിലെ സ്ത്രീകൾ, കുടുംബശ്രീ പോലുള്ള പ്രസ്ഥാനങ്ങളെ ശാക്തീകരിക്കാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നതാണ്. അതിന് KSDMA മുൻകൈ എടുക്കണം എന്നാണ് എൻ്റെ അഭ്യർത്ഥന. മാത്രമല്ല നിരവധി തലത്തിലുള്ള കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻ ചാനൽസ് ആവശ്യമാണ്. ഞാൻ ഇന്നലെ ഒരു വെബിനാറിൽ സൂചിപ്പിച്ചതുപോലെ ബ്രെയിൽ സിസ്റ്റം ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടി വരും, സൈൻ ലാംഗ്വേജ് ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടി വരും, ബിഗ് പ്രിന്റ് വലിയ പ്രിന്റ് ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടി വരും. ഇങ്ങനെ വ്യത്യസ്തമായിട്ടുള്ള ചാനൽസിൽ കൂടി അറിവ് പരമാവധി ആളിലേക്ക്. ഏറ്റവും എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു ഈ കോവിഡ് അക്കാദമി 19 എന്നതിന്റെ സംഘാടകരെ അങ്ങേയറ്റം അനുമോദിക്കുകയാണ്, ശേഖറിനെയും വിക്രാന്ത്ജിയെയും വിജേഷിനെയും ഒക്കെ. കാരണം താരതമ്യേന സാമ്പത്തിക ഭാരം കുറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് ഏറ്റവും അധികം ആളുകളിലേക്ക് അത്യാവശ്യം എത്തേണ്ട സന്ദേശങ്ങൾ എത്തിക്കാൻ സാധിക്കുന്ന ഒരു സംവിധാനമാണ് നിങ്ങളിപ്പോൾ ആരംഭിച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന കോവിഡ് 19 അക്കാദമി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അതിന് ഞാൻ ഓരോരുത്തരെയും പ്രത്യേകം അനുമോദിക്കുന്നു, അഭിനന്ദിക്കുന്നു. ഇതൊരു വളരെ വിജയപ്രദമായ ഒരു കാര്യമായി ഭവിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് ആശംസിക്കുന്നതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ നേരത്തെ ശ്രീ ശേഖർ സൂചിപ്പിച്ചതുപോലെ ഇതിന്റെ സസ്റ്റൈനബിലിറ്റിയും വളരെ പ്രധാനമാണ്. കോവിഡ് 19 നിന്നും മറ്റു പല കാര്യങ്ങളിലേക്കും പോകാൻ സാധിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് ആശംസിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി ശ്രീ വിക്രാന്തിനും ശ്രീ ശേഖർ കുര്യാക്കോസും വിജേഷിനും ഒക്കെ പ്രത്യേകം അനുമോദനങ്ങൾ അറിയിക്കുകയാണ്. കാരണം കേരളം എന്നും പല കാര്യത്തിലും KSDMA മുൻപന്തിയിലായിരുന്നു. അതുപോലെ മറ്റൊരു ഫസ്റ്റ് അടിച്ചതിന്റെ ഒരു ലക്ഷണമാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് കോവിഡ് അക്കാദമി കേരളത്തിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവരാൻ സാധിച്ചു എന്നുള്ളത്. എല്ലാവരുടെ പിന്നിൽ നിന്നും പ്രവർത്തിച്ച എല്ലാ അണിയറ പ്രവർത്തകരെയും അങ്ങേയറ്റം അനുമോദിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ശുഭാശംസകൾ നേർന്നുകൊണ്ട് എന്റെ വാക്കു വെച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു. നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം.
താങ്ക് യു മാഡം. നൗ ഐ റിക്വസ്റ്റ് റാഫി പി, സീനിയർ പ്രോഗ്രാം അസോസിയേറ്റ്, WFP, ടു ഡെലിവർ ഹിസ് ഫെലിസിറ്റേഷൻ അഡ്രസ്.
Rafi, you are muted. Please unmute your mic.
Rafi, you are unmuted. Please speak more.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
And most of the participants are from Kerala, so I'll be opting Malayalam. Roma Asthavanamai Pravartikana Aikirashtra Sabayude oru logathiletum biggest title humanitarian organization aanu World Food Program. ഇന്ത്യയിലെ നമ്മുടെ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾ ഈ കോവിഡുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ട് പ്രധാനമായിട്ടും നമ്മൾ NIDM നാഷണൽ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ഓഫ് ഡിസാസ്റ്റർ മാനേജ്മെന്റുമായിട്ടും നാഷണൽ ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ഓഫ് നാഷണൽ ഡിസാസ്റ്റർ മാനേജ്മെന്റ് അതോറിറ്റിയുമായിട്ടൊക്കെ WFPയിലേക്ക് അവർ ലിങ്ക് ഇപ്പം ധാരണയിൽ ഏർപ്പെട്ട് വർക്ക് ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത്. തിരിച്ചും ഫുഡ് സെക്യൂരിറ്റി ആൻഡ് ന്യൂട്രീഷൻ മേഖലയിലെ പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്നതായതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഇതുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട ഒന്ന് രണ്ട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ മാത്രം പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് എന്റെ ഫെസിലിറ്റേഷൻ അവസാനിപ്പിക്കാം എന്ന് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നു. WFP ഈ കോവിഡിന്റെ ഇമ്പാക്റ്റുമായിട്ട് ഫുഡ് ആൻഡ് ന്യൂട്രീഷൻ സെക്യൂരിറ്റിയിലേക്ക് ചർച്ച ചെയ്തപ്പം പ്രധാനമായിട്ടും 5 കാര്യങ്ങളാണ് കണ്ടിട്ടുള്ളത്. ഒന്ന്, ഫുഡ് അവൈലബിലിറ്റി നമ്മൾ കാര്യമായിട്ട് തന്നെ അഫക്ട് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ് മനസ്സിലാക്കിയിട്ടുള്ളത്. രണ്ടാമത്തെ, പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ കപ്പാസിറ്റീസ്, ഇത് ഞാൻ പറയുന്ന ബാക്ക്ഗ്രൗണ്ടാണ് പറയുന്നത്. രണ്ട്, പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ കപ്പാസിറ്റീസിനെ കാര്യമായിട്ട് അഫക്ട് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. പിന്നെ ഇത് അസസ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ളതിന്റെ അസെക്സും കോംപ്രമൈസ്ഡ് ആയിട്ടുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ് നമ്മളുടെ ഇനീഷ്യൽ അസസ്മെന്റ് മനസ്സിലായിട്ടുള്ളത്. അതിന് പ്രധാനമായിട്ടുള്ള കാരണങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുള്ളത് ഒന്ന് ലോസ് ഓഫ് ലൈവ്ലിഹുഡും ഡിഗ്രിയും ഡയവേഴ്സിറ്റിയാണ്. അതിൽ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മള് ഡയറ്റ്സ് ഒക്കെ മോസ്റ്റ്ലി ഒരു ഷെൽഫ് സ്റ്റേബിൾഡും അത് പ്രീ പാക്കേജ്ഡ് ഫുഡിലേക്കൊക്കെ മാറ്റി അത് മുന്നോട്ടുള്ള അവസ്ഥയിൽ അത് പ്രധാനമായിട്ടും മാൽ ന്യൂട്രീഷനൊക്കെ അഫക്ട് ചെയ്യും എന്നുള്ളതാണ് നമ്മളുടെ ഒരു കണ്ടെത്തിയിട്ടുള്ളത്. പിന്നെ അഞ്ചാമത്തെ പോയിന്റ് ആയിട്ട് നമ്മൾ അസസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ളത് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മുടെ മാർക്കറ്റുകളിലെല്ലാം സ്റ്റെബിലിറ്റി കോംപ്രമൈസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്, അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഒരു അൺസെർട്ടനിറ്റി ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. ഈ 5 പോയിന്റുകളാണ് ഫുഡ് ആൻഡ് ന്യൂട്രീഷൻ സെക്യൂരിറ്റിയുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ട് നമുക്ക് അസസ് ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. ഇനി കേരളത്തിന്റെ അവസ്ഥയിലേക്ക് വരുമ്പോൾ ഭക്ഷ്യസുരക്ഷ നിയമം അതിന്റെ ഭദ്രത ഏറ്റവും ഉറപ്പാക്കിയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു സ്റ്റേറ്റ് എന്നുള്ളത് കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഫുഡ് അവൈലബിലിറ്റിയുമായിട്ട് കാര്യമായിട്ടുള്ള പ്രശ്നങ്ങളൊന്നും കേരളത്തിൽ കണ്ടെത്താൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടില്ല. അതിൽ പ്രധാനമായിട്ടുള്ള എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ PDS നെറ്റ്വർക്ക്, പബ്ലിക് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ സിസ്റ്റം നെറ്റ്വർക്ക് ഒക്കെ നന്നായിട്ട് തന്നെയാണ് നടന്നിട്ടുള്ളത്. ന്യൂട്രീഷന്റെ ഫോക്കസിലേക്ക് വരികയാണെങ്കിൽ പ്രധാനമായിട്ടും ICDS സെക്ടറും മിഡ് ഡേ മീൽ സെക്ടറും ഒക്കെയാണ് ഇവിടെയാണ് എടുത്തു പറയേണ്ട ഒന്ന് രണ്ട് കാര്യങ്ങളുള്ളത്. ഒന്ന്, ICDS സെക്ടറിന്റെ 6 മാസം മുതൽ 3 വയസ്സ് വരെയുള്ള കുട്ടികൾക്ക് അമൃതം ന്യൂട്രിമിക്സ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് കൊടുക്കുന്നുണ്ട്, ഫോർട്ടിഫൈഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള കൊടുത്തിട്ടുള്ളത്. സാധാരണയായിട്ട് ഏകദേശം 4-4.5 ലക്ഷമോ കുട്ടികൾ മാത്രമാണ് അക്സസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഇന്നിപ്പോ ഈ കോവിഡിന്റെ പീരീഡിലേക്കും അത് ഏകദേശം 585,000 കുട്ടികൾ ആക്സസ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. അതായത് ഏകദേശം 1,50,000 കുട്ടികൾ കൂടിയിട്ടുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. ഇതിൽ ഏറ്റവും പ്രത്യേകത എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ കുടുംബശ്രീ വഴി പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് അവർ നമ്മൾ എക്സ്പെക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്ന ആ ലെവൽ അവർ മീറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ അവർക്ക് ഈ കോവിഡിന്റെ പ്രതിസന്ധികൾ സാധിച്ചു എന്നുള്ളത് അഭിനന്ദനാർഹമാണ്. കുടുംബശ്രീ അഭിനന്ദിച്ചേ പറ്റുള്ളൂ. രണ്ടാമത് ICDS 3-6 കുട്ടികൾക്കുള്ള കൊടുക്കുന്ന മിഡ് ഡേ മീൽ ഇപ്പോൾ ടേക്ക് ഓമറേഷൻ ആയിട്ടാണ് കൊടുക്കുന്നത്. 3 മാസത്തേക്ക് അഡ്വാൻസ് ആയിട്ട് കൊടുക്കുന്നത് അതും സാധിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. മിഡ് ഡേ മീലും പാക്കഡ് ആയിട്ട് മിഡ് ഡേ മീലും ഇതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഫുഡ് കിറ്റ്സ് ആയിട്ട് വരുന്നുള്ളതെന്നുള്ളതും നമുക്ക് നല്ല ഒരു ഇൻഡിക്കേറ്റർ ആയിട്ടാണ് കാണാൻ വേണ്ടി സാധിക്കുന്നത്. എന്നിരുന്നാലും ഒരു ഏരിയ മാത്രമേ എനിക്ക് കൺസേൺ ആയിട്ട് തോന്നിയിട്ടുള്ള ന്യൂട്രീഷൻ്റെ ഏരിയയിൽ. ഇപ്പം 6 വയസ്സ് കഴിയുമ്പോൾ അംഗൻവാടിയിലെ കുട്ടികൾ പോവുകയും അവർ 6 വയസ്സ് കഴിയുമ്പോഴത്തേക്കും അവർ സ്കൂൾ 1-ാം ക്ലാസ്സിലേക്ക് ചേരുകയും ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് സർക്കാർ സ്കൂൾ സാധാരണയായിട്ടുള്ളതായിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പം അവർക്ക് ഈ മിഡ് ഡേ മീൽ ആ സമയത്താണ് ആക്സസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്നത്. അപ്പം ഈ അംഗൻവാടിയിൽ നിന്ന് പോവുകയും ചെയ്തു എന്നാൽ ഒട്ട് സ്കൂളിലേക്ക് ഇപ്പം അഡ്മിഷൻ സമയം ഇല്ലാണ്ടിരിക്കുകയും വരുമ്പം ആ ഗ്യാപ്പിലുള്ള കുറച്ച് കുട്ടികളുണ്ട്. അവരുടെ ഫുഡ് അക്സസബിലിറ്റിയുടെ എന്താണ് സ്റ്റാറ്റസ് എന്നുള്ളത് കണ്ടറിയേണ്ടിയിരിക്കുന്നു. എന്നിരുന്നാലും ബാക്കി സംസ്ഥാനങ്ങളൊക്കെ അപേക്ഷിച്ചിട്ട് കേരളത്തിൽ ഫുഡ് സെക്യൂരിറ്റി ഇൻ വ്യൂ ഓഫ് ദി ഇമ്പാക്ട് ഓഫ് കോവിഡ്-19 കുറച്ചുകൂടി സേഫ് ആണ് എന്നുള്ളതാണ് എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. ലാസ്റ്റ് പോയിന്റ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കേരള ഡിസാസ്റ്ററുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ 2018 സ്ഫിയറിന്റെ മുൻകൈ എടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് IAG പറഞ്ഞ ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഉണ്ടാക്കി, ഇന്റർ ഏജൻസി ഗ്രൂപ്പ്. അതിൽ നമ്മളെല്ലാവരും അംഗങ്ങളാണ്. അതിൽ അപ്ഡേറ്റുകളെല്ലാം വരുന്നുണ്ട്. ആ ഒരു ബാക്ക്ഗ്രൗണ്ട് ഉള്ളത് കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഈ കോവിഡ് അക്കാഡമിയുടെ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾ കേരളത്തിൽ ഏറ്റവും നന്നായി നടക്കുമെന്നുള്ളതിനാണ് വിശ്വാസം. ഇത് സംഘടിപ്പിക്കാൻ മുന്നോട്ട് വന്ന കേരള സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഡിസാസ്റ്റർ അതോറിറ്റിയെ വേൾഡ് ഫുഡ് പ്രോഗ്രാമിന്റെ പേരിൽ അഭിനന്ദിക്കുന്നു. താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്.
നമ്മൾ കാത്തിരുന്നത് പോലെ ഹരികിഷോർ സർ ജോയിൻ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. സറിന്റെ ഇനോഗ്രേഷൻ സ്പീച്ചിന് വേണ്ടി വി ആർ വെയിറ്റിംഗ്. ഹരികിഷോർ സർ ഹാസ് ജോയിൻഡ്. ഐ റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ഹിം ടു ഇനോഗ്രേറ്റ് ദ പ്രോഗ്രാം കോവിഡ്-19 അക്കാഡമി ഫോർമലി.
യെസ്
സർ, യു ആർ സർ, യു ആർ ഓഡിയബിൾ.
ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ സോറി ഫോർ ദ ഡിലേ. എനിക്ക് രാവിലെ ഒരു മീറ്റിംഗ് ഉണ്ടായത് കൊണ്ടാണ് കൃത്യസമയത്ത് എത്താതിരുന്നത്. ഹാപ്പി ദാറ്റ് യു ഹാവ് കംപ്ലീറ്റഡ് ദ മോർണിംഗ് സെഷൻ. ഇത് കേരളത്തെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം വലിയ അഭിമാനമുള്ളൊരു കാര്യമാണ്. കേരള സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഡിസാസ്റ്റർ മാനേജ്മെൻറ്റ് അതോറിറ്റി സ്ഫിയർ ഇന്ത്യ NDMA സഹായത്തോടുകൂടി
sound boy sir.
His voice is not coming, Dr. Shekhar.
Sir, your voice is went off. He'll come back.
Yeah, am I audible now, Shekhar?
We can hear you, sir. We can hear you.
Now there is no problem. Should I speak in English or Malayalam? What is the preferred language?
Sir, larger audience is Malayalam, but we have experts from across the country.
I'm saying it would be better. Or you can mix up. You can mix up both so we can understand Malayalam also.
Okay. Thank you very much. So... Here the team is organizing COVID-19 Academy, especially to prepare our resilience with larger goals. This is a great initiative. Above all, our local team leaders of our SDMA.
we are not able to hear you.
ഇപ്പോഴും പ്രശ്നമാണോ ശേഖർ?
Yes, sir. We are not able to hear you.
Give me 2-3 minutes. Let me try something else.
How you are audible, sir?
Oh my God. ഇപ്പോഴോ?
അതെ സർ, ഇപ്പോൾ കേൾക്കാൻ പറ്റും.
Okay, maybe I'll try once again, and if it is.
Maybe it will help if you could, if you are switching off your video.
ഹലോ, അതിൽ 45 വേണ്ട എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. 45 എന്നുള്ള സാധനം അത് വരണമെന്നില്ല. 45 വരണമെന്നില്ല. അങ്ങനെയാണ് ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞത്. 45 അല്ല, 45 വേണ്ട എന്നുള്ളത്. അതായത് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് അംഗനവാടി സർവീസുകൾ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു ഒരു സേവനം തന്നെയാണ് കുട്ടികളുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുള്ള പ്രധാനമായിട്ട്. അപ്പം കുട്ടികളുണ്ട്, അമ്മമാരൊക്കെ ഒരു സേവനമായിട്ട്.
ഹലോ ഹരികൃഷ്ണ സർ, അറിയതേ?
ഒരു ടാഗ്ലിന് അത് 45 വർഷം തേക്കാണ് സർവീസ്. അപ്പൊ അതുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട കുറച്ച് ഈ 45 വർഷത്തിന്റെ കുറെ പ്രോഗ്രാമുകൾ ഉണ്ട്. അപ്പൊ അതിന്റെ ഒരു ടാഗ് ലൈൻ ആയിട്ട് കൊടുക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി. അപ്പൊ അത്
ഡോക്ടർ ശേഖർ, വി ലോസ്റ്റ് യു. ഹി ഈസ് ദേർ ബട്ട് നോട്ട് എബിൾ ടു ഹിയർ. ശേഖർ സർ, ആർ യു ദേർ?
Been Shekhar sir attending another meeting, so shall we move on to the next speaker? Our next speaker is a professor from Loyola College of Social Work. He is Father Saji Joseph. So I request Father Saji Joseph to deliver felicitation.
Respected dignitaries and esteemed participants, can you all hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Good afternoon. It gives me pleasure and happiness to rise in response to the launching of one of the creative and collaborative ventures, COVID-19 Academy Kerala. At the outset, I appreciate everyone for having worked hard to realize the COVID-19 Academy Kerala. COVID-19 pandemic has permeated into every fabric of India, every nook and corner of India. The medical and social milieus have designed multiple disciplinary interventions with an eclectic paradigm in India, particularly in Kerala. Launch of COVID-19 Academy Kerala is going to be yet another milestone in the annals of Kerala. Global media showered praises on the ruling government for its astute COVID-19 response. Professor Benjamin Jeffrey had talked about what makes Kerala an outlier on multiple counts, including its coordinated campaign to contain the viral pandemic. Kerala soon came in for praise from sociologists and political scientists. They emphatically reiterated that caste and class distinctions had radically diminished in Kerala over the course of the 20th century. They articulated that when it came to implementing the provisions of the 73rd and 74th amendments to the constitution, Kerala was ahead of other states. Every fabric of Kerala society is founded on a solid socialist and progressive ideal. The history of Kerala is the history of democratic socialism. The state is home to different religions and they coexist peacefully without many exceptions. Various dimensions of Kerala model of development are written, rewritten, spoken extensively. But Kerala model of disaster management is not written enough, not spoken enough, not documented enough. So we, the faculty members, eminent scholars, alumni and students of Loyola College, a premier institute of social sciences, have engaged in drafting a new postgraduate program to train and mold the new generations of learners. Master of Social Work in Disaster Management is a unique and innovative PG course to showcase the experiences and strategies of Kerala floods and highlight the most innovative and creative ways of combating the world frightening pandemic COVID-19. It would enable Loyola College to impart professional training to their building budding social workers in disaster management in collaboration with KSD, MA, Kudumbashree and Sphere India. These budding professionals are going to be the frontline workers and catalysts for policy change. We would work together to combat COVID-19 pandemic through a completely non-conventional paradigm of disaster management. Through online COVID-19 Academy, we are going to transcend the territorialities. We are going to transcend the caste and creed. And we are going to transform the mindset of people and establish a system of upholding values and ethics. A spectre of disaster is what India is vulnerable to. One third of India's area is prone to severe floods and droughts. Every disaster reverses the 25 to 30 years of human development. So we need to instill in the young minds the need for disaster mitigation and disaster risk reduction. This is going to be an amazing platform, online platform for Kerala to impart very solid training to the frontline workers, especially the industry workers and the academic institutions. So we are going to join hands with the eminent NGOs and GOs to build the models of intervention. And this platform is going to pave a path for imparting and establishing the models of intervention. And I really appreciate Dr. Shekhar L. Kuriakose for having placed Loyola College on record the interventions that we have been doing, and we are going to do it as a new postgraduate course. And I appreciate everyone for having taken this initiative to set up this academy. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Father Sadji. Hari Kishore sir is back. Hope his connection is back. Hari Kishore sir.
Yeah, we... Okay. Now I am in the Wi-Fi.
Yes, sir. Please continue.
Sure. So... Yeah.
First of all, let me place my appreciation to ND Air India and all others who are working towards establishing this COVID-19 Academy. And from our end, Kudumbashree is very happy to be part of this novel initiative. I could not join you in the beginning. There was a company and it just got out of you before you conclude the inaugural ceremony. Initially, let me speak about Kudumbashree and its various activities during COVID and flood. During COVID, community network took a lot of initiatives along with government or as per the direction of government. The list is huge. Like one policy which we have taken is to provide immediate financial assistance to all the people. About 24 lakh stepped through a novel scheme called Chief Minister's Helping Hand Scheme, where interest-free loan was provided. This is for the first time in the country that we are providing such an assistance. All the banks have agreed to provide loans and interest, and government is giving the interest subvention of 9%. So effectively, every community member is getting money at 0%. And about average loan size is about 8,000-10,000 rupees, and has reached 24 people. So because of lockdown, people lost their jobs, and we are able to provide immediate financial support. That is one policy. Government of Kerala came up with another policy of setting up community kitchens. Local governments, we were able to establish community kitchens in 4 days. More than 1,300 community kitchens were established, and 1,100 kitchens were run by Kudumbas. Another initiative is in livelihood, where we are producing masks. More than 70 lakh masks are produced. We were able to give an opportunity of 8 crore rupees to the members. Another novel step would be communication. As you all know, it is very difficult to communicate right news to the right people, to the real community through various channels. So we formed about 3 lakh WhatsApp groups with 20 lakh members, and we started communicating messages from government, precautions to be taken, information about Break the Chain campaign, etc., to all the people. Now the group is active, and we are also propagating news like Grand Care, where the people with comorbidities, people above 60, should take extra care to fight against COVID. Okay. So I am mentioning about different verticals. One is about opportunities, one is about providing fund, one is about supporting the community through community kitchen, another is about communicating. So there are multiple angles of our intervention, and it is continuing. But at the same time, these are the interventions which is happening in the field. It's essential, always. And this novel initiative will provide the and our officials with required theory, with best practices from across the world, with ideas, with inputs, with motivation, and whatnot. So we have great hopes on the initiative. And these 12 hours of classes, I'm sure that will benefit the community to reflect on their activities. It will help them to get a good orientation. It will help them to take initiatives with leadership, so that they are aware of the various techniques, they are aware of various best practices, they are aware of various theories and processes and thoughts for taking leadership and initiative. And we have good hopes on the contents, and we hope that the quality of the content also will be of highest standards. We have great hopes, because what was the gap in Kudumbashree, what is the gap in the society, is the right knowledge. We are good in action, we are good in developing bottom-up policies, but fine-tuning the policies into a very meaningful and organized manner is also essential. So I am very
hopeful that NDMA, SDMA, Spear India, everyone is here and everyone joined together is organizing this academy. My request would be to take a feedback of all the sessions and kindly understand the requirement of the community. I am sure that you have understood the requirement of the community while framing the course. In implementing the course, take a second feedback, and based on the feedback, we are willing to round of training and capacity building, because capacity building is very essential for fighting COVID. Capacity building of the community, the courage of the community, their preparedness and their active involvement is essential. And for the I have great hopes on the. We hope that this will make a real impact and real difference to the people, to the state of Kerala. And my best wishes to all the participants, my best wishes to all the organizers, and my appreciations and thanks to the organizers for taking this initiative forward. Formally, I inaugurate the training program, but however, you know, the real inauguration is by our community, and they will own it, and they will make the best out of this training. Thank you very much, and best wishes.
Thank you, Kishore sir. On behalf of the organizers, I would like to extend heartfelt thanks for joining us in your from your busy schedule and inaugurating this COVID Academy. Now I move on to the person behind this COVID Academy, Mr. Vikrant Mahajan, who is the Chief Executive Officer of Sphere India. I invite for his felicitation remarks.
Thanks, Joe. Thanks, Dr. Shekhar. Shri Harikeshwar ji, the other eminent speakers today. I think it's a great feeling for me to be part of this inaugural of Kerala COVID-19 Academy. I think as already shared by Sarabjit and other things, this COVID Academy, the phase one at a national level has been a big success. And since the corona and the digital technology, you know, we might have broken the barriers, the boundaries, states, national. I think it's possible for all of us to connect digitally on one platform and create exchanges and media for experience sharing. Still, what we got the feedback from the phase one, there was a need felt to do more practical, skill-oriented trainings in the vernacular language. And that's also in our consultation with the NDMA and other partners came out as a direction ahead that we look at more trainings and more sharing in vernacular languages, and we create platform for that. And it's a feeling of immense joy that what excellent place other than Kerala to start this another experience, you know, in collaboration with KSDMA and other important members of Sphere India. So what we see that in this academy, I think calendar, there is Vijesh has already worked out 12 sessions plan for the month of September and October. But as I hear Shri Harikeshwarji also, I think I'll encourage that we in this time frame, we understand the other training requirements, which he was just mentioning about of the grassroots volunteers. We take note of that maybe through an exercise for training need assessment or something like that. And probably in the beyond October, what additional sessions can be planned, we look at that. And one of the directions from the NDMA is also to see that the Prime Minister's 10-point agenda for DRR, you know, that we have more awareness around that. And on the various agenda items, it's in itself, for example, one of them brings out the various academic institutions together, network them and create a common knowledge platform in the state, I think is already happening with the great initiative and thinking of Dr. Shekhar by involving a lot of academic organization in this inaugural and the in the session plans and designs ahead also. I also see that with the academy, we will again get the opportunity to network and bring more between the interagency group, potentially the others, security organization, KSDMA, a more coordination, more collaboration will emerge from that, and we learn from that and we move forward. As Dr. Shekhar was has been saying that yes, this is COVID Academy, but maybe the need is there for a larger DLR or disaster management academy we need to look at. This is something which really has been on our mind also. We have been contemplating it a lot. Is certainly a discussion which is happening in this phase, and maybe a transition will happen in a few months from this COVID Academy to the maybe a larger DLR or DLR Climate Risk Academy. At this stage, many of our members and many of our thinkers feel still think that we need to have a more focus on COVID while we look at the subjects, the sessions and discussions. We have to be looking at the multi-hazards and the multi-hazard preparedness and the issues emerging from the local context, but they will to see them in the COVID context. And it's the while in many places the COVID peak is being anticipated, but it's another wave is being anticipated. I think India is still very high on the curve of vulnerability, and so there's a long road ahead on the COVID also. So maybe the focus still need to be on the multi-hazard issues in the COVID context. So that's what has been the thinking of the core members behind this initiative at the national level. But definitely, as being advised by Dr. Shekhar, we will see a transition happening in a couple of months from now. Lastly, I think is with this, I would like to see that to what additional sessions we plan it, what different kind of the knowledge pool we can create from the state, and other states also take a learning from the experience of Kerala, and we move forward. So with this back again, I thank Dr. Shekhar, I thank Hari Kishoreji, I thank other officials of the government of Kerala, the colleagues there, and the eminent speakers today who have put their minds and put their hearts behind in making a very successful initiative. Thank you, everybody. Over to you, Joe.
Thank you, Vikrantji. Now we have some time to clarify any doubts if the participants would like to ask anything to the organizers. As you are aware, today is just the launch. From tomorrow, we would be starting the technical sessions. So we have in the agenda just a vote of thanks. So prior to that, if any of the participants who have joined would like to ask in English or Malayalam, we would be happy to respond to that. We will wait for 2 minutes.
We have two raised hands from Mr. Mohammed Naushad. One, I'll unmute you, Mohammed Naushad. Kindly.
Yes, please.
Morning.
Good afternoon. Please ask. We can hear you.
Yeah. I'm Mohammed Naushad from Castropol. I'm sorry for late joining.
Naushad, your audio is not clear.
Yeah, now it's not clear. Can you repeat what you asked?
I am sorry for joining for late. Okay.
Sir, what is your question? What? Yeah. Please ask the question. Yes.
എന്തെങ്കിലും
ചോദ്യമുണ്ടോ? ചോദ്യം ചോദിക്കാനായിട്ടുണ്ടോ?
ഇല്ല, ഒന്നുമില്ല, പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഒന്നുമില്ല.
ഓക്കെ, വി വിൽ മൂവ് ടു ദി നെക്സ്റ്റ് പേഴ്സൺ. താങ്ക് യു. എനി ഹൂ എൽസ് ഇസ് ദെയർ ബീൻ
അറ്റൻഡ്?
Do we have Srikutan PR? I'll unmute you, Srikutan. Srikutan, yeah, please raise your question. Okay, we will move on to Shamsuddin. Shamsuddin, I'm going to unmute you. Shamsuddin, Chaudhary Joyce.
Okay, sir. I am Shamsuddin from Healthcare Foundation Disaster Management Team, Kerala, Calicut. Hello. Okay. Thank you. Then, ഇപ്പൊ കോവിഡ് ആയിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട് സന്നദ്ധ പ്രവർത്തകർ എന്ന നിലക്ക് ഒരു എൻജിഒസ് എന്ന നിലക്ക് നമുക്ക് കോവിഡ് ആണെങ്കിലും മറ്റെന്താണെങ്കിലും ഒറ്റക്ക് കൂട്ടമായിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു പ്രവൃത്തിയാണല്ലോ. അപ്പോ ഒരു എൻജിഒസ് എന്ന നിലക്ക് നമുക്ക് വേറെന്തെങ്കിലും ചെയ്യാനുണ്ടോ? ഈ ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട അതോറിറ്റി മുഖേന അല്ലാതെ മറ്റെന്തെങ്കിലും ചെയ്യാനുള്ള റോളുണ്ടോ? കോവിഡിന്റെ പശ്ചാത്തലത്തിലാണ് പറയുന്നത്.
അതെ സാറേ, സാറിന്റെ ജില്ല ഏതാണ്? ഈ എൻജിഒ പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്ന ജില്ല
കോഴിക്കോട് ജില്ല.
അതെ, അപ്പൊ കോഴിക്കോട് ജില്ലയിലെ ജില്ലാ ഭരണകൂടമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെടണം. അവിടെ ഈ എൻജിഒസിന്റെ ഒരു പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം ഉണ്ട്, ഇന്റർ ഏജൻസി ഗ്രൂപ്പ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം ഉണ്ട്. അതില് താങ്കളുടെ എൻജിഒക്ക് രജിസ്റ്റർ ചെയ്യാം. അപ്പോ അവര് ജില്ലാ ദുരന്തനിവാരണ അതോറിറ്റി നൽകുന്ന നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങൾ അനുസരിച്ച് സന്നദ്ധ സംഘടനകൾക്കും എൻജിഒസിനും പ്രവർത്തിക്കാം.
ഓക്കെ, ഓൾറെഡി ഐഎജി ഹെൽത്ത് കെയർ ഫൗണ്ടേഷന് എക്സിക്യൂട്ടീവ് അംഗമാണ്.
അതെ അതെ, അപ്പോ അവരുടെ നിർദ്ദേശപ്രകാരം പ്രവർത്തിക്കാം. നമ്മളിപ്പോൾ ഈ സംശയ നിവാരണം പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത് ഈ കോവിഡ് അക്കാഡമി ആയിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ടുള്ളതാണ്. അപ്പോ അതായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുള്ള സംശയങ്ങൾ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ചോദിക്കാം. പൊതുവിലുള്ള സംശയ നിവാരണത്തിനുള്ള സമയം നമുക്ക് മറ്റൊരു അവസരത്തിൽ എടുക്കാം.
ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്. ഞാൻ ചോദിക്കാം, പിന്നീട് ചോദിക്കാം.
ജോ, നമുക്ക് മറ്റു ചോദ്യങ്ങളൊന്നും ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സിലോ വരുന്നില്ല. ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സിലുള്ള ഒരു ചോദ്യം ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് ഫോമിനെ കുറിച്ച് ഡീലിയ ചോദിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. മേ ബി ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നോട്ട് എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, ബട്ട് മേ ബി ഷീ ഈസ് ട്രൈങ് ടു ആസ്ക് വെദർ ദർ ഈസ് എ ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് ഫോം ടു അവർ സെഷൻ.
ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് ഫോം ഇന്നത്തെ ഒരു ലോഞ്ച് പ്രോഗ്രാം ആയതുകൊണ്ട് ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് ഫോം ഇല്ല. നാളെ മുതലുള്ള സെഷൻസിന് ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് ഫോം നൽകുന്നതായിരിക്കും. അതിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക് രേഖപ്പെടുത്താവുന്നതാണ്. ഓക്കെ, ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓക്കെ? മേ ബി വിജീഷ് നാളെ തൊട്ടുള്ള പരിശീലന പരിപാടിയുടെ ഒരു പെട്ടെന്നൊരു ബ്രീഫ് കൊടുക്കാമോ? അതിന്റെ ലിങ്കും കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ എങ്ങനെയാണ് അത് പബ്ലിക്കിന് അവൈലബിൾ ആവുന്നത്?
താങ്ക് യു ജോ. നമ്മൾ മുൻപ് പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ തന്നെ 12 സെഷൻസ് ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഈ ഒരു ആദ്യ ഫേസിൽ നമ്മൾ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇതുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട ഞാൻ സെഷൻസിനെ കുറിച്ച് വളരെ ബ്രീഫായിട്ട് 12 സെഷൻസിനെ കുറിച്ച് പറയാം. അതത് ദിവസം തലേ ദിവസങ്ങളിലായിട്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ ഇതുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട ഫ്ലയേഴ്സ് നമ്മൾ റിലീസ് ചെയ്യും. അപ്പം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭ്യമായിട്ടുള്ള നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നേരിട്ട് തന്നെ ഇത്തരം ഫ്ലയേഴ്സ് ലഭ്യമാകുന്നതായിരിക്കും. അതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ സ്ഫിയർ ഇന്ത്യയുടെ വെബ്സൈറ്റിലും ഫേസ്ബുക്ക് പേജിലും ഈ ഫ്ലയേഴ്സ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭ്യമായിരിക്കും. ഓരോ ദിവസത്തെ മീറ്റിംഗിനും നമ്മൾ ഒരു ലിങ്കാണ് നമ്മൾ ക്രിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഇന്ന് എങ്ങനെയാണോ നിങ്ങളിത് ആക്സസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ളത് സമാനമായിട്ട് തന്നെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ആക്സസ് ചെയ്യാം. ഇപ്പൊ കുടുംബശ്രീ പ്രവർത്തകരാണെങ്കിൽ കുടുംബശ്രീയുടെ ഉദ്യോഗസ്ഥരുമായിട്ട് സംസാരിച്ചതിന്റെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ വാട്സപ്പ് ഗ്രൂപ്പുകളിലും മറ്റു ഒരുമിച്ച് ഉള്ള മറ്റു ഫോറങ്ങളിലെല്ലാം തന്നെ ഇത് അതത് ദിവസങ്ങളിൽ ഉച്ചയോടുകൂടി നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അടുത്ത ദിവസത്തെ ഫ്ലയറുകൾ ലഭ്യമാണ്. വളരെ വേഗത്തിൽ ഞാൻ പറയാം, നാളെയാണ് നമ്മുടെ ആദ്യത്തെ സെഷൻ. നാളെ നമ്മൾ തിരുവനന്തപുരം മെഡിക്കൽ കോളേജിലെ ഡോക്ടർ അനീഷ് ആണ് നമുക്ക് വേണ്ടി സെഷൻ നയിക്കുന്നത്. അതിൽ നമുക്ക് റിസ്ക് കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻ ആൻഡ് കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റി എൻഗേജ്മെന്റ് എന്ന വിഷയത്തിലാണ്. നമ്മുടെ 12 സെഷൻസും നമ്മൾ പ്രാദേശികമായിട്ടുള്ള മലയാള ഭാഷയിൽ തന്നെയായിരിക്കും നമ്മുടെ 12 സെഷൻസും ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കുക. നിങ്ങളുടെ പങ്കാളിത്തത്തിന്റെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇതുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട സർട്ടിഫിക്കറ്റ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നൽകുന്നതായിരിക്കും. നമ്മുടെ രണ്ടാമത്തെ സെഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഒക്ടോബർ 1st ആ ഒരു സെഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് കോവിഡിന്റെ മുന്നണി പോരാളികളായിട്ടുള്ള ആളുകൾ ഏത് തരത്തിലുള്ള സുരക്ഷാ മാനദണ്ഡങ്ങളാണ് പാലിക്കേണ്ടത് ഈ ഒരു വിഷയത്തിലാണ് നമ്മുടെ രണ്ടാമത്തെ സെഷൻ. മൂന്നാമത്തെ ഒക്ടോബർ 3rd ആണ് ഉള്ളത്. അത് നമ്മൾ കോവിഡ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സമാനമായിട്ടുള്ള വിഷയങ്ങളിലെ എന്താണ് ജെൻഡറുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട വിഷയവുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ 3 ഒക്ടോബർ 3 അത് ഡോക്ടർ ബി വത്സലകുമാരി നമ്മുടെ മാഡം തന്നെയാണ് ആ ഒരു ക്ലാസ് കൈകാര്യം ചെയ്യുന്നത്. 1-ാം തീയതിയിലെ ക്ലാസ് ഞാൻ പറയാൻ മറന്നുപോയി. ഡോക്ടർ രതീഷ് ആണ്, അദ്ദേഹം ഗവൺമെന്റ് മെഡിക്കൽ കോളേജ് ട്രിവാൻഡ്രത്തെ അസോസിയേറ്റ് പ്രൊഫസർ ആണ്. തുടർന്ന് 5-ാം തീയതി ഒക്ടോബർ നമുക്ക് കോവിഡ് കാലത്തെ നമ്മുടെ മാനസികാരോഗ്യ സംബന്ധമായ വിഷയങ്ങളുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട് നമ്മുടെ സ്റ്റേറ്റ് നോഡൽ ഓഫീസറായിട്ടുള്ള മെന്റൽ ഹെൽത്ത് പ്രോഗ്രാം സ്റ്റേറ്റ് നോഡൽ ഓഫീസറായിട്ടുള്ള ഡോക്ടർ കിരണിന്റെ ക്ലാസ്സായിരുന്നു നമുക്കുണ്ടാവുക. എല്ലാ ക്ലാസ്സുകളും ആവർത്തിച്ച് പറയുന്നു 11 മണി മുതൽ 12 വരെയാണ് എല്ലാ ക്ലാസ്സുകളും. 11 മണി മുതൽ 12 മണി വരെ 1 മണിക്കൂർ ക്ലാസ്സും തുടർന്ന് അരമണിക്കൂർ ഡിസ്കഷനുമാണ്. ഞാൻ ആദ്യത്തെ 2 ദിവസത്തെ ക്ലാസ്സുകളുടെ വിവരങ്ങൾ ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സിൽ ഇട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്, നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അത് പരിശോധിക്കാവുന്നതാണ്. തുടർന്ന് നമ്മുടെ 7-ാം തീയതി നമുക്ക് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് കുടുംബശ്രീ ഉൾപ്പെടെയുള്ള സന്നദ്ധ സംഘടനാ സംവിധാനങ്ങളുടെ കോവിഡിന്റെ പശ്ചാത്തലത്തിൽ ഉള്ള അവരുടെ പ്രത്യേകമായിട്ടുള്ള റോളുകളെ കുറിച്ച് നമുക്ക് 7-ാം തീയതി ബെഡ്റോക്കിന്റെ സിഇഒ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ആനി മാഡം ആണ് നമുക്ക് ആ ഒരു ക്ലാസ് കൈകാര്യം ചെയ്യുന്നത്. തുടർന്ന് 9-ാം തീയതി എങ്ങനെയാണ് ദുരന്ത നിവാരണ രംഗത്ത് എങ്ങനെയാണ് പ്ലാനിങ് എന്നതിനെ കുറിച്ച് UNDP യുടെ മുൻ പ്രൊഫഷണലായിട്ടുള്ള ജി പത്മ